The under fire minister, Persis Namganza, was expected to tender in her defense today before the Mwini Mpaka led ad hoc committee, was instead represented by her lawyer, Norman Pandey, which did not appease committee members.
Rule 1098, the president is the one supposed to transmit these documents to your client. So you hope us confirm, did the president actually transmit these documents to your client or not? Two, I need you to help us confirm, did your client receive the invitation from our clerk inviting her for this meeting? Three, was your client aware of the censure proceedings at Parliament?
The lawyer could not confirm to the committee whether his client received summons to show up and defend herself on allegations levelled against her in the censure motion. Neither could he confirm whether the president served the minister upon receiving documents of censure motion from Parliament.
If the president had given the minister these documents 14 days before the select committee had been set up, you would not be telling us we gave you the information, the evidence, a day two, because we expect you to have these documents. But out of courtesy, this committee again sent this evidence to you so that you come prepared to respond. So now, the question is simple. Did the president transmit these documents to your client or not?
Gave her the documents or not? All she gave me is the file that he forwarded to her, that he had the answer, the notes of motion, only that.
Legislators then tasked the lawyer to prove that he was instructed by his client to appear on her behalf, but Pandey failed to adduce written instructions. He was asked to call the minister on his phone, but she didn't pick.
Confirm to us that you are here to represent Honorable Namuganza, and you are from this law firm, Mwanja, and the Pandey Advocates.
The instructions, because it is a serious matter, God forbid, if at all something went wrong and we are on the floor presenting, the Honorable Minister can actually say she did not send a representative. Because we do not have written instructions, actually we are not sure if we should actually consume all the information you have given us, right? Because we are not yet sure if the Honorable Minister actually sent you. You have tried to reach her, yet she's aware you are here, and she has refused to pick your calls. Okay, maybe she has not refused, maybe she's busy. But how can we ascertain that you are actually here and everything you have given us should be put on record as a representative of the Honorable Minister? Therefore, we are going to request you. I wouldn't want to take that route, but we are going to give you 10 minutes or 15, whichever time you need, to give us those instructions. Otherwise, we may consider you to be an imposter.
Mr. Chairman, I beg to submit the instructions from my client in writing, like I have done previously, at a date not being today. Like I have informed you, I have moved out, called her, she has not picked.
I thought
as when, for now, I leave it to the committee to decide what to do on this matter.
Counsel, no.
Because I am being put on the wall, I am trying to explain. I am telling you, no advocate in this country, of all places, you appear before Parliament to be an imposter, to represent somebody in the cameras. So on that basis,
Chair, order,
on that
order,
basis, I request
Chair,
for time
order,
to submit written instructions
order.
To this committee. That is all I can say now.
The lawyer submitted that the committee proceedings contravene the sub judice rule, saying the minister has already served the Speaker and the Attorney General over the matter since they challenged Parliament in courts of law.
That the Speaker, I mean the Clerk of Parliament, the Attorney General, are part of the court proceedings. Some of them have even filed responses to the court cases, and they are aware of the hearing dates.
But aware that it is either the Speaker or the presiding officer of the particular committee or meeting to determine whether the matter is sub judice or not. And for him or her to make a decision, of course, facts must be read before him. The pleading is referred to for him to determine that it's something which you also know that.
After a stalemate, The committee bounced the lawyer and the chairperson Mpaka, decided to give the minister more time up to Monday next week to defend herself. The attempt to serve Namganza with evidence against her through her lawyer flopped as Pande declined to take responsibility.
You are here. We need to give you all the evidence we collected yesterday so that you help us and transmit it to your client.
Mr. Chairman, I can't take it now. It would be prejudicial. I need to know what I'm receiving. It's not a matter of receiving things. It's not a matter of receiving things. No, I can't receive it now.
You can't read.
I can't receive it now.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.